Hello everyone, my name is Maddie of The Girly Geek and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm coming at you with a lovely little plan with me for a beautiful spread that I've done for this upcoming week. And I thought I would just take this as an opportunity to have a nice little calm moment amongst the chaos that's going on in the world right now. So I thought we could take a moment to, you know, relax, sit back, talk about nice, pleasant things. So feel free to grab a cup of tea. It's about 11 p.m. I'm sitting at my desk with my favorite candle burning and a cup of tea that I'm nursing, and honestly, it feels really great. I think it will be nice to talk about the things I'm really enjoying doing right now to help lift my spirits and hopefully yours as well. We've all kind of been thrust into this incredibly stressful and overwhelming situation that, you know, none of us could have expected. So I thought this would be a nice opportunity just to talk about the positives, things I enjoy, things that are helping to keep me sane right now, such as planning, reading, drawing, and creating. So speaking of creating, the theme for this spread I wasn't so sure of at the beginning, but I did want it to be something that was kind of calming and light, not too loud, because I don't know, things have been very loud lately and overwhelming, and you know, my brain feels a little crowded, so I wanted a really simple color palette, something that was tame, something that was calming. So when I started my initial search for stickers, I pulled out a couple of the more pastel themed sticker books, the Free Spirit, two of the wellness ones, the digital detox one, and also the pastels one. The first two stickers that I kind of plucked and built my theme around were from the wellness, or the most recent wellness sticker book. So it was the one that says inhale exhale in a lovely pale pink with rose gold accents, and then another that was like a checklist of, you know, what I'm feeling. So I chose those two as they had similar color palettes, and then I kind of built around that with the same pale pinkish peach color and rose gold for this theme. And then I fell in love with the stars in the Free Spirit sticker book and kind of went a little nuts with that. But I think it looks absolutely beautiful when I paired it with some of the florals, the pale pink florals from the flower sticker book, and those gold stars. I think it's one of my best spreads yet, if I'm being completely honest. It's so stunning. And it's a really nice change from my usual themes. I've been doing a lot of bright mixed pastel spreads lately because, you know, they're really nice and cheery, but I feel like this is a more appropriate time for something more tame and calm. And you'll see that the quotes that I've chosen for this spread also kind of reflect that. They will focus on, you know, breathing, staying sane, emphasizing self-care and things like that, which are very necessary for all of us right now. I did have a pretty big existential crisis last week when it came to the whole, you know, university situation and how they were handling things, because they weren't handling them, and I almost deferred. My university was still open and still running classes, and one of the classes I'm taking this semester is like completely face to face, and I was really worried about my grades slipping and obviously having to go and possibly expose myself to the virus, which I really didn't want to do since I do have underlying health conditions. So I was having a bit of a meltdown on Monday, but luckily by Tuesday there was an announcement and we've kind of got a solution. But you know, we're in uncharted territory. Everything's a bit weird right now. Nobody really knows what's going on. Things are up in the air. Assessments are being shuffled around. So yeah, who knows what the future holds, honestly. We just gotta take it one day at a time. But the biggest part of my stress is over, which I'm really glad about. The solution for my university was kind of a pause, I guess, on all the classes. They moved up our mid-semester break to give us a little bit of a pause so they could sort out bringing everything online. which isn't ideal for a lot of people, but I'm super thankful that at least we have that as an option, because I do value my health and obviously the health of my family and everyone else, and am doing my part to, you know, socially distant. So yeah, I've been at home ever since, and for the week that I'm doing this spread, I will also be at home doing a little bit more work because there is some prep for assignments coming up. We don't know the exact dates, but they are looming somewhere. So hopefully this can be a nice, calm, but a little bit productive week for me. I also want to factor in a bunch of other activities that I enjoy. One thing that's keeping me sane at the moment is drawing. I've been doing a lot more drawing, actually. Since my little brother is home from daycare, I usually watch him during the day, and I can't get a lot of uni work done, but I can draw while I'm supervising him. So I've been doing a lot of doodling, and I've made a few more desktop backgrounds that I've been sharing on my Tumblr. I'm going to be posting them every Friday again for Freebie Friday. Last week's one was a really cute like lemon blossom design, which I had a lot of fun doing. I actually like did that like in the middle of the night at like 2 a.m. but I got carried away. Sometimes you just have an idea and you start and your hand just, you know, keeps going, and that's what happened to me. But I really loved the result, and a couple of you guys said you did too, so I'm really happy about that because it's been really calming. I also have been doing a lot more reading. I'm still on a pretty big romance kick since last year. Like my favorite reads of at the end of last year were The Flatshare, One Day in December. Those were really nice, wholesome reads that were just so comforting. And I've been reading a lot more of those lately as well, because, you know, this is a weird time. I just want to feel wholesome and warm and fuzzy inside. So I just recently finished R Stop by Laura Jane Williams, which was really funny and really sweet, and I loved that. I am now currently reading Emergency Contact by Mary H.K. Choi, which I know a lot of people have hyped up, and I've owned a copy of it since about 2018. But I've yet to read it because I haven't been that into YA recently. But I'm about 70 pages in, and it's good. It's not the most exciting, but I am enjoying it so far. So hopefully in the next week, this week that I'm doing the spread for, I can find a lot more time to read. My goal is probably 2 books, because I have a little bit more time. And I've already made a start on Emergency Contact, so maybe I can squeeze another short one in there. But I don't want to pressure myself too much, because when you make things feel like a chore or a job, then it starts to lose its novelty and fun, and that's not what I want at all. Oh, and another book that I really enjoyed reading this year, back in January, was Little Fires Everywhere. I actually today just started watching the first episode of the Hulu adaptation, and it's really good so far. I really love the book, so of course I hope that it will live up to the, you know, hype of that story. It's really good so far, so I'm very hopeful. And yeah, so I'm hoping to do more reading, maybe watch another episode of that, of Little Fires Everywhere. And get some prep in for my assignments that are coming up. Who knows when, but they're coming up sometime, so I may as well get myself prepared, get a little head start on them. And back on the topic of books, I'm always looking for new reads, of course. My physical TBR pile is out of control, and I also have a lot of ebooks that I've yet to read. But if you have any cool suggestions, then I'd love to know. Leave it in the comments down below and we can nerd out about books together. One of my favorite things to do. As you can see on the screen now, I'm starting to go in with those rose gold stars, which I am low-key obsessed with. Well, not really low-key. I'm obsessed with them. They're so like dainty and cute. They're so cute. But yeah, I think they look stunning with the florals and the color scheme of this spread. So So I used them to fill up a bunch of the empty spaces and make things look a bit less square. I really love the effect that it has on the overall spread. I'm honestly in awe of this spread. I love it so much. It's one of my favorites, if not my favorite, and it came together surprisingly quickly for me. It came together in about 33 minutes, which is a lot shorter than usual. My spreads take on average an hour. Like, I can't remember the last time I did a spread in under an hour. So this was surprising, to say the least, especially for a spread of this quality, of this caliber, if you know what I mean. Like, it's a nice one. Go me. I think it's a personal best. Anyway, I'd love to hear about how you guys are dealing right now, what it's like in your country, what you're doing to stay sane, how it's impacted your academic life and things like that. I think the only good thing about this is that everyone's kind of coming together and joining forces to fight this thing. So I would love to hear about how you're dealing with it. I know it's a bit scary because everything is like so out of our control, but I find that it helps me to focus on the things that I can control, like doing my work and, you know, planning, doing things, creating things. So I also want to create, or rather keep creating, content. I've been pretty regular on Instagram and liking the photos I've been taking and sharing there lately and seeing everyone else's. It feels really nice to see how everyone's dealing with things in the same way. And since I am inside my house for the foreseeable future, I would also like to take some opportunities, especially in the upcoming week, to film some more content, put out a new video. I do have one that's already filmed and half edited, but I'm debating whether or not that one should actually go up. I filmed a kind of like study with me / normal week in my life vlog when I was at uni before things really got crazy. So I'm not sure if I should post that. It's not really that exciting. I literally just do a bunch of reading and note taking. I personally think it's a bit boring and I don't know, it's like 23 minutes long, so I'm not sure how interesting that thing is, but I do know a lot of people like watching study with me videos, even if it feels really mundane, or even study in real time videos. So definitely let me know if that's something you'd like to see anyway. But yeah, not sure if you guys want to see that, so let me know if you do. Otherwise, I get a ton of requests all the time to do an updated desk tour. So my 2017 desk tour is actually like my most viewed video. It kind of like got way more attention than I was ever expecting, and it still gets a lot of views to date. And a lot of people have asked for an updated version, so I'm open to doing that as well. So if you have any suggestions or something that you really like to see from me, then be sure to let me know about that too. I do think it would be nice to do an updated desk tour. My desk looks a little bit different to before, not that much, but you know, people get nosy about other people's spaces. I know I do. I love to know what other people's spaces look like. I think it reveals a lot about their personality and things like that. So yeah. So here is the completed spread for this week, which honestly, it brings me a lot of joy to look at it. I think this spread turned out really, like really adorably, like so stunningly. So I really hope that you found a moment of calm in this video and that you find a little bit of delight in this spread or this conversation as I have. Thank you so much for watching and spending some time with me today. I really hope you enjoyed this video. Be sure to like and subscribe if you want to. I hope you all stay safe, strong, and in good health. And I'm really excited to see you guys again soon. Bye!